look at the question, students. Find the direction in which the straight line must be drawn through the point P minus 1 comma 2, so that its point of intersection with the line x plus y equal to 4 may be distance of 3 units from the point. Okay. So see, students. So this is the one point, and that is this is one line, and that is one line. So the point P, you have minus 1 comma 2, and one point is x plus y equal to 4, and second straight line we are going to find. So the second straight line we are going to find. Okay, is the first straight line x plus y equal to 4? This is the equation number 1. Okay, now the points minus 1 comma 2, and slope you can have answered by m. Slope you have answered by m. Now you have a formula. So one point and one slope is given. What is that? Y minus y1, which is equal to m into x minus x1. So y minus y1 is y minus 2, which is equal to m into x minus x1, so x plus 1. M into x plus 1. Now I'm going to substitute, multiply inside this mx plus 1. And y equal to mx plus 1 into m. Minus 2 comes this side, plus 2. So this is the value of y. Y equal to mx plus m plus 2. Okay. Now see, to have first equation, no. Shall I substitute the value of y in first equation? Okay. Now the first equation, x plus y equal to m plus 2, which is equal to 4. Okay, now x plus mx plus m, otherwise x plus mx, which is equal to 4 minus 2 minus m. I am going to move these two terms and right side. Now you have a common of x is taking outside to get x into 1 plus m, which is equal to 4 minus 2 is 2. So 2 minus m. Now the final answer, x equal to, you get it by 2 minus m by 1 plus m. So this is the value of x. Okay, now I am going to substitute the value of x in equation number 1 or that already you have known, y equal to. So that part is not wrong. How to substitute to get that value of y? Okay, so take this equation number 2. So equation number 2 I am going to substitute. So y equal to, or like simply how to substitute that equation. Okay, equation number 1 is a no problem. It is an easy method. So to take x plus y, which is equal to 4. So y equal to 4 minus x. Okay, so taking a cross multiplication, 4 minus 2 minus m by 1 plus m. So taking the cross multiplication, which is equal to 4 into 1 plus m minus 2 minus m divided by 1 plus m. Okay, so y equal to 4 plus 4m minus 2 plus m whole divided by 1 plus m. So y equal to 4 minus 2 is 2, then plus 5 m whole divided by 1 plus m. Okay, so this is your value now. What is that? Y. Okay, finally got it at coordinate of Q. So consider this is a Q. So consider the coordinates of Q is, what is that? 2 minus m by 1 plus m, 2 plus 5 m by 1 plus m. Okay, already they gave you that. What is that? Distance. What is the distance? So the distance is 3 units. So distance between both, from what are they? PQ. Okay, now Q you have, P you have minus 1 comma 1. Now substitute the formula, square root of x2 minus x1 or x1 minus x2. Okay, so 2 minus m by 1 plus 1 minus x2, so plus 1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1, y1 minus y2, so 2 plus 5 whole divided by 1 plus m minus m whole square, which is equal to 3. Now I'm going to cancel the square root to get what is that? Right side become 3 square 9. 3 square 9. Okay. Now squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. Okay. Now take the cross multiplication of this 2 to get 2 minus m plus 1 plus m whole divided by 1 plus m the whole square plus this also the same 2 plus 5 m by taking a cross multiplication like this, students. Okay. So 2 plus 5 m minus 2 minus 2 m the whole divided by 1 plus m the whole square, which is equal to 9. Because this hypotenuse also take over. Okay. Now the simplification 2 plus 1 is plus m minus m cancel. So 2 plus 1, I mean 3. So 3 by 1 plus m the whole square plus here plus 2 minus 2 cancel, so 5 minus 3 2 m is 3 m. So 3 m by 1 plus m that whole square, which is equal to 9. Now square to get the answer, 3 square is 9 by 1 plus m the whole square plus 9 m square by 1 plus m the whole square, which is equal to 9. Okay. Now you have a common denominator, that is 1 plus m the whole square. Yes. Now expand a plus b the whole square, that is 1 plus m square plus 2 m, which is equal to 9. Okay. Now is taking 9 outside to get 1 plus m square. 9 I can cancel. So 1 plus m square, which is equal to 1 plus m square plus 2 m. 1 not cancel, m square cancel. So 2 m equal to 0. M also become equal to 0. Okay, so slope is 0, mean what will come? That is parallel to x axis.
Parallel to x axis.
Have you got it, children?
Okay.
This is your final answer. What are the question asking? So the PQ is 0, means what is that there? Find the direction that which the straight line must be drawn through the point minus 1, 2, so that the point of intersection with the line x plus y equal to 4 and the distance of 3 units from the point is the parallel axis.
Parallel to x axis.
Okay, so we got this thing. And next question. Next question number 18. This is a very important question from 6 mark. Okay, so listen carefully. So based on this question, you have a 12th question also. Put out the perpendicular image of the point. Okay, so listen carefully in that. Question number 18. Okay, yes. I am reading the question, listen. Find the image of the point 3,8 with respect to the line x plus 3y, which is equal to 7. Assuming the line to be a mirror, plane mirror. Okay, so plane mirror can see this is the point of A and B. Okay. Downside of Q, I am going to consider H, K. H, K. Okay, so first it is very simple. So from the first equation, this is your equation number 1. So from the equation number 1, you have to take a slope M. Slope M. Okay, so you have two methods of finding the slope. One is y equal to M, convert of it. I mean frame of y equal to mx plus c, that form, and to find the value of slope the slope when the straight line is given, you have a formula minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y. So minus coefficient of x means minus 1 by 3. So it is very simple, minus 1 by 3. What is the formula? Minus coefficient of x whole divided by coefficient of y. Okay, now students listen. So the slope of AB and this is the O like that. Take that. So slope of OB AB and OP is perpendicular. Okay, which is perpendicular. Slope of AB into slope of OP which is equal to minus 1. Do you know the perpendicular condition? M1 into M2 which is equal to minus 1. M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1. So slope of AB, the slope of this minus 1 by 3 into the slope of OP is M, consider, which is equal to minus 1. So minus minus cancel, M equal to plus 3. M equal to plus 6. Now, take the point M. You take point M. So, the point P comma D and the slope M equal to 3. So, from these two, you have to find the equation of line. One point and one slope. You have y minus y naught. So, y minus A which is equal to M into x minus x naught. So, x minus A. So, now, so to simplify now, 3x minus 9 minus y plus 8 equal to 0. So the final answer, you get it by 3x minus y minus 1 equal to 0. So this is equation number 2. This is equation number 2. Now solve equation number 1 and 2 to get. So for that, this also, I am taking y equal to minus 1. Minus y moving that side, plus y now. So y equal to 3x minus 1. So take and substitute in equation number 1. Otherwise, using the elimination method also, it's not a problem. Okay, now x plus equation number 1. X plus 3y now. So 3 into 3x minus 1, which is equal to 7. So x plus 3, 3 is 9, x minus 3 which is equal to 7. So x plus 9 is 10x which is equal to 7 plus 3, 10. So 10x equal to 10, you have a value of x equal to 1. Now you have a value of x is 1 and x equal to 1. To substitute any one of the equation to get 1 plus 3y equal to 7. So 3y equal to 7 minus 1, 6. So y equal to 2. Y equal to? So this is the point of intersection O is 1 comma 2. So the point of intersection O is 1 comma 2. Okay. Now I am going to take a midpoint in comma. Okay. That is 1 comma 2. Shall we consider AB? A is the point of x1 and x2. X1 comma y1. And B is the point of x2 comma y2. Consider x1 y1. X2, Y2. Okay, now midpoint of AB is 1, 2. Now X1 plus X2 by 2. X1 plus X2 by 2. Otherwise, and see, you have one more point here, that is P3, A. Again, so see, X1 plus X2 by 2. Y1 plus y2 by 2 which is equal to 1 comma 2 which is equal to 1 comma 2. So take a T, not like this, not midpoint of A. Don't want to take midpoint of A. That is P R, I mean PQ. So in that PQ, O is the midpoint. So if you take like this, it is very simple because here the two points also you don't know, but then you have 1 point. No. So take the easy part of midpoint of PQ. So midpoint of PQ which is equal to 1 comma 2 and half P is 3 comma 8, 2 is h comma k. So 3 plus h by 2 comma 8 plus k by 2 which is equal to 1 comma 2. Now compare the what it means to get 3 plus h by 2 which is equal to 1. So 3 plus h equal to 2, h equal to 2 minus 3 is minus 1. And next, So this is an image of point. Image of the point that is Kachikamaki is what are they? -1, -4. What is your final answer? -1, -4. That is Q. Okay? So the image of the point is -1, -4. Okay? And the next question. So the next question. Question number 19. So listen, students. If the line y equal to 3x plus 1 and 2y equal to x plus 3 are equally inclined to that line y equal to mx plus 4, then find the value of m. So one line and the two lines are equally inclined to one line, that is y equal to mx plus 4. So we want to find that value of m. Okay, now first I am going to consider y equal to 3x plus 1 and y equal to m plus 4. Okay, now m1 equal to 3 and m2 equal to m. Because already you have the same pattern y equal to mx plus c. So no problem, directly you have to take. Now, angle between the two lines. So what are they? Tan theta which is equal to m1 minus m2 modulus of. So 3 minus m whole divided by 1 plus m. 1 plus m. Okay. And the same way I am taking. Take the next two things. That is 2y equal to x plus 3 and y equal to mx plus 4. So here I need the correct form of y equal to mx plus 3. So for that I am going to divide the whole equation to get x by 2 plus 3 by 2. Always multiply 2 want to move in that right side. Okay, here the same y equal to mx plus 4 only. Okay, yes. Now, again the angle between the two lines, m tan theta equal to m1 is 1 by 2 minus m whole divided by 1 plus 1 by 2 into m. Okay? So 1 minus 2m whole divided by 2 whole divided by 1 plus m by 2, which means what is that? 2 plus m by 2. So here 2 cancel. Okay, now what will come? 1 minus 2m whole divided by 2 plus. So this is equation number 2 and that is equation number 1. On both also, you have a tan theta. You have a tan theta. So from the one, equation 1 and 2, you have a tan theta is equal. So I am going to equating 1 and 2. From 1 and 2, you get, by what is that? 3 minus m by 1 plus 3m, which is equal to 1 minus 2m by 2 plus m. Now taking a cross multiplication to get 3 minus m into 2 plus m which is equal to 1 minus 2m into 1 plus 3m. So now multiplying 3 is 6. 3m minus 2m minus m square. Minus m square. Which is equal to 1 plus 1. 1 into 3m, 3m. Minus 2m minus 6m square. 6m square. Okay, now 6 plus m, 3m, plus 3m minus 2m, m minus m square which is equal to 1 plus m minus 6m square. Okay, now m will cancel. Okay, now minus 6m square will be that side and plus 6 on to that side. So 6m square minus m square. 1 minus 6. So 5m square which is equal to minus 5. Now m square is equal to minus 1. Okay. So this is a less than one, you know. Okay. So we can't get it the answer. So for that, I'm going to take a negative. Okay. So negative means 3 minus m by 1 plus 3 m, which is equal to minus of 1 minus 2 m whole divided by 2 plus 8. 2 plus. So minus I'm going to multiply to get 2 plus m into 3 minus m, which is equal to minus 1 plus 2 m into 1 plus 0. Okay. Now multiply to get the answer. The same here. 6 minus m by r. 6 minus m plus 3 m. 2 3 are 6 sir. 2 m. 2 m. 6 minus 2 m. And plus 3 m and minus m square, which is equal to minus 1. Minus 3 m. Plus 2 m. Plus 6 m square. Plus
6 m square.
Okay. Now 6 plus m minus m square, which is equal to minus 1 minus m plus 6 m square. Now I'm going to take one out of any side, that is 6 m square minus m minus 1 plus 6, that's like minus 6, plus 1 means minus 1, minus m square plus m square is equal to 0. Okay, so 6 m square plus m square is 7 m square minus 2 m minus 7 equal to 0. So what will come? 7 m square minus 2 m minus 7 equal to 0. So check. So it will not practice. So simply use the quadratic formula. You have a quadratic formula, what is that? Minus b. Minus b means minus of minus 2. Plus of minus square root of b square is 4. Okay. Coefficient of n square is a. Coefficient of m is b. And the constant of the c. So minus of minus 2 plus of minus. Minus 2 of square minus 4 into a into c. Whole divided by 2 into 7. 2 into? So now minus 2 minus plus 2 plus or minus 4 minus 4 into 4. 49 on. Okay, minus 7. Minus minus plus. So 4 into 49. No, multiply. 7 times of 49 into 4. 9 times of 36 remainder 3. 4 times of 16. 19. That is 1964 divided by 14. So 2 plus or minus square root of 200 whole divided by 14. So 200. 100 into 2 1. 100 into. Okay. Now taking 2 plus or minus 10 to 2 whole divided by 14. So take the common term of 2 in outside. You get 1 plus or minus 5 into 2 whole divided by 14. So it will be cancelled, 1 plus or minus 5 into 2, the whole divided by 7. Okay. So negative is not possible means, just you have to take the slope, m equal to 1 plus 5 into 2, the whole divided by 7. So this is entirely different from the previous step machine. Okay.
Less or minus 7, that's not the problem.
So this is your final answer. The value of m is 1 plus or minus 5 into the whole divided by
7.
Okay. And the next question, number 20. So look at the question number 20. The sum of the perpendicular distance of the variable point P, x, y.
The variable point P, x, y.
From the lines x plus y minus y equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0 is always 10. Then show that P must go on a line. P must go on a line. You have a distance formula, modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c whole divided by square root of a square plus b square. Already you know this. Now the sum of the perpendicular distance is given, that is which is equal to 10. Okay. for that the distance b equal to ax1. So the point already given, the point p is x comma y. P is x comma y. Now a, the value of a is 1 and x plus b is also what, x into. See, x are what I think. No problem. Only p x and only y. Minus y is whole divided by square root of 1 square plus 1 square, which is equal to x plus y minus y by square root of 2. The square root of. Okay, so this is your first distance. And next, take the second distance. Take 3x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0. So that is also you have the same point only. So take the 3 into x minus 2 into y plus 7 whole divided by 3 square plus 2 square. So for that, 3x minus 2y plus 7 whole divided by 3 square 9, then 4 or 2 square 4, so root 13. That is root D. That is D. Okay, now we will substitute the sum of the perpendicular distances. So sum of perpendicular distances is equal to 10. Is equal to 10. So now x plus y minus 5 by root 2 plus 3x minus 2y plus 7 by root 13, which is equal to 10. Which is equal to 10. Now taking a constant place, these two lines, root 13 x plus root 13 y minus 5 root 13 plus 3 root 2 x minus 2 root 2 y plus 7 root 2 the whole divided by root 2 into root 13, which is equal to 10. Okay? Now I am going to compare the terms of x, that is root 13 plus 3 root 2 into x plus root 13 minus 2 root 2 into y, and the constant terms are plus 7 root 2 minus 15 root 2 the whole divided by root 26, which is equal to 10. Which is equal to 10. Okay, now I am going to simplify, that is x into root 13 plus 3 root 2 plus y into root 13 minus 2 root 2 plus 7 root 2 minus 15 root 2. You get it here. What is it? Minus 8 root 2, which is equal to 10 root 26. So which is your third answer, 10 root 26. Okay, otherwise taking the terms of, what is the remaining? So taking the terms of x into root 13 plus 2, 3 root 2, that is your back answer. Y into root 13 minus 2 roots, 2 root 2 plus 7 root 2. Oh, that is 5 root 13, huh? Okay, yeah, sorry. This is the 5 root 13. So you can't simplify. So taking the same, minus 7 root 2 minus 15 root 13, which is equal to 10 root 26. Okay, so this is your final answer. Okay, and so the next question number 21. So listen to the question number 21. Find the equation of the line which is equidistant from the parallel line 9x plus 6y minus 7 equal to 0 and 3x plus 2y plus 6 equal to 0. Okay, so these two lines are also equidistant from the parallel line, you know. Okay, so first 9x plus 6y minus 7 equal to 0. Now divided by 3 to get 3x plus 2y minus 7 by 3, which is equal to 0. And the second one, 3x plus y plus 6 equal to 0. So compare this, the coefficient of x term and y term are both also same only, no? So do you know the parallel condition formula? Yes. The two lines are parallel. The condition is a1x plus b1y plus c1
which is equal to the same ax plus by plus c 1 equal to 0 and ax plus by plus c 3 equal to, I mean the both two coordinates are x coordinate and y coordinate also same, but the y is the constant term only, no, that's only different. Okay, now I am taking the equation of parallel line 2, 1. That is, you have a 3x plus 2y plus k equal to 0. Okay, so this is a parallel line. This is a parallel line. Okay, now I'm going to take those two and that. Okay, to take, do you know the distance? The parallel is the distance between the parallel lines d equal to c1 minus c2 the whole divided by square root of a square plus b square. Okay, so take 3x plus 2y minus 7 by 3 and 3x plus 2y plus k equal to 0. Now take the distance d equal to c1 minus c2 in what will come? C1 is minus 7 by 3 and c2 is plus k. Plus k. Will come the distance d equal to minus 7 minus 3k the whole divided by 3 the whole divided by 3 square is 9 and 2 square is 4, so 9 plus 4 is 13, square root of 13. So you have minus 7 minus 3k whole divided by 3 equal to 13. And take the next two lines, that is 3x plus 2y plus 6 equal to 0. And the parallel line 3x plus 2y plus k equal to 0. So these two lines also I am going to take a distance between the two parallel lines d which is equal to c1 minus c2, that is 6 square plus k the whole divided by 3 square plus 2 square. So 6 minus k whole divided by 2 square root of 14. So that's all. So compare the first and second equation to get here minus 3. I mean, if you are repeating the what to get 7 plus 3k whole divided by 3 root 13, which is equal to 6 minus k whole divided by root 13. So root 13, root 13 cancel. So 7 plus 3k, which is equal to 6 is the 18 minus 3k. Now 3k plus 3k which is equal to 18 minus 7. Okay, now 18 minus 7, 3 plus 3 is 6k which is equal to 11, k equal to 11 by 6. So what is our answer question? So k is given. So this is a equation of parallel line. I am going to substitute the equation number 1, that is 3x plus 2y plus k is 11 by 6 equal to 0. Now removing the denominator, for that I am multiplying by 6 to get 18x plus 12y plus 11 is equal to 0. So this is your final answer. And then the next question, question number 22. So listen student, this is a different question. A ray of light passing to the point 1,2p. The point P 1,2. The point P 1,2. Okay. So that point P 1,2, that is passes reflects on the x axis. So this is the x axis. So which means what will come? K comma 0 only. Consider K comma 0, because on the x axis it will come only the x coordinates. So that's why I have mentioned by K comma 0. So the point P which is reflects. Passes to the point P, reflect on A, and then which is reflect to the another ray, the point R is 5,3. R is 5,3. Now find the coordinates of A. And again, I read the question, listen carefully. A ray of light passes reflect on the x-axis on the point B, and the reflector, the ray passing to the point again R is phi comma B. Now find the coordinates of A. So from the figure we understand one thing, that is A is perpendicular to OX or x-axis. OX or x-axis. Okay. Now the two angles are equal. That is the first angle. SAR, which is equal to PAS. PAS. So now listen. SAR, which is equal to PAS, on both also the same angle. Okay. Now this is the angle of theta. Now XAR, which is equal to theta. Now this angle, how it comes to the angle? 180 minus theta. Okay, 180 minus theta. Now the first one I'm going to take a slope of the two points A and R. Slope of A R. So the point A is A comma 0 and R is y comma 3. You have a formula y2 minus y1. Y2 minus y1. So y2 is 3 minus 0 whole power by x2 minus x1. X2 is 5 minus 8. So the value is 3 by 5 minus 8. So 3 by 5 minus 8. And second, the slope of AR we find that. And next I am going to find the slope of AP. The other end, opposite line. Slope of AP. So here also, x2 minus x1. Sorry, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. That is 2 minus 0 divided by k minus 1. So 2 by k minus 1. 2 by k minus 1. Okay. So this is the equation number 1 and that is equation number 2. Now both these also reflect no. So the slope will come is equal to 1. The slope will come equal to 1. Okay. Now from the equation 1 and 2. Now 2 by 1 minus k. So this is equation number 2. Here tan theta, this one is tan. This point is coming on the line, on the point. This ray passes through A and reflected to the point R. Okay. So already told you this is a theta and that is 1 minus, I mean 180 minus theta. 180 minus theta. So 180 minus theta already you know from the third quadrant. Third quadrant or second quadrant? Second quadrant. Second quadrant sine and cosine only pass you know. So tan theta negative. So minus tan theta which is equal to 2 by 1 minus k. So delta is equation number 2. So from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2. Tan theta which is equal to minus tan theta. So this is tan and this is minus tan. Now I'm going to substitute 3 by 5 minus k which is equal to minus 2 by 1 minus k. Now taking a cross multiplication, 3 minus 3k which is equal to minus 10 plus 2k. Okay, now minus 3k moving, that's it, minus 10 this side. So 2k plus 3k which is equal to 3 plus 10. So 5k which is equal to 13. K equal to 13 by 5. So this is on the point, record point A is 13 by 5 comma 0. 13 by 5 comma 0. So this is your final answer. So then the last question, question number 24. I am reading the question is this. A person standing at the junction crossing the two straight path represent by the equation. So the person he is standing the two roads junction like this. The two lines are going to have 2x minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0 and 3x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. Okay, straight path represent by the equation. Wants to reach the path whose equation of this? The person wants to reach the path equation of this 6x minus 7y plus 8 equal to 0. In least time, in least time. So find the equation of the pond he should follow. It is very simple scenario. See, one person is standing here, okay, and we have a two ponds. The first pond, the PA equal to 2x minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0, and the second pond, the PB equal to 3x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. And he wants to go the path, this one is mentioned by O on the PO. So this time is 6x minus 7y plus 8 equal to 0, that is the least time. So that one we are going to find. So this equation of PO or PR, this one we are going to find. Okay, suppose I am going to solve the two equations. What are they? Equation number 1 and equation number 2 by elimination method. Okay, you get the equation number 1, which is multiplied by 4 to get 8x by minus 1y plus 16 equal to 0, and equation number 2, which is multiplied by 3 to get 3 is 9x plus 12y minus 14 is equal to 0. Now I'm going to cancel that. So 8 plus 9 is 17. X plus 1 equal to 0. Then 17x equal to minus 1. And x equal to what will come? X equal to minus 1 by 17. So for that I'm going to substitute by the equation number 1 to get 2 into minus 1 by 17 minus 3y plus 4 equal to 0. So therefore 3y minus 3y 1 on that side, which is equal to minus 2 by 17 plus 4 plus 4. Okay, now taking a cross multiplication of this minus 2 plus 17, 4 are 30, 17, 2 are 34, 68 4 divided by 17. Okay, so 3y which is equal to 66 by 17, because minus 2 plus 68 so 1 3 is 17, 22 3 is 66. 22 3 is 66. Now you have a value of y equal to 22 by 17. Now that point, what is that value? The point O of Q vanish. Okay, it's correctly P, take like that. So the point Q is minus 1 by 17 comma 22 by 17. The point is minus 1 by 17 comma 22 by 17. Okay, so for that I'm going to take, see, one point you are getting now, and next what you are going to find, the slope I'm going to find. Okay, so first take here 66 minus 7y plus 8 equal to 0. Minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y. So for that m equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of y. So minus 6 by minus 7. So the slope m equal to 6 by 7. So the slope m is equal to 6 by 7. Okay. So perpendicular slope only we are going to find now. So the perpendicular, because it is perpendicular, so the perpendicular slope is minus 7 by 6. How do you know? M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1. So use that formula, or this very simple formula, the perpendicular slope is minus 1 by M. Okay, now take the points. So the point, what is that? The point Q is intersection of this perpendicular formula. The point P is, P don't want to take that. Q is minus 1 by 17 comma 22 by 17, and the slope is minus 7 by 6. Slope is minus 7 by 6. Okay, now you have one point and one slope to find that equation of sine wave. So y minus y0, that is y minus 22 by 17, which is equal to m, you have a minus 7 by 6 into x minus x0 give x plus 1 by 17. X plus 1 by 17. Okay, now taking a cross multiplication, 17y minus 22 by 17, which is equal to minus 7 by 6 into 17 plus 1 by 17. So these two 17s are cancelled out. Okay. Now I'm going to multiply this 17, 6 are 6 are 42, remainder 4 on 6 are 6, 102 plus 7 is equal to 0. So the final answer 108 + 102y -125 is equal to 0. So this is your required answer. Okay, yes, student. So up to this question, we have completed the miscellaneous exercise for the chapter 10. Okay, so we'll meet in that next class. Thank you, students.